Hello, this is Sumita Gupta welcoming you all for my next lecture of electronic devices in circuit, that is thermal consideration and the heat sink. Okay, if you have remember in the last lecture we have done all the class A and class B power amplifier. So today we will learn what is the concept of heat sink, what is the thermal consideration of the power amplifier, means what is the requirement of the heat sink, and we will see the analogy of heat sinking along with the problem exercises. Now, first of all, the question, what is heat sink? So you can understand the word heat sink means to sink some heat, okay? Means to remove some heat from the transistor and dissipate into the surrounding air. And it should be efficiently as much as possible. So heat sink is a component which is used to remove the heat. Which is we use to remove the heat from a transistor and dissipate into the surrounding air. So that is done by the heat sink. Heat sinks take many different forms, such as fine aluminium, copper sheets, blocks, often painted or anodized matte black to help dissipate the heat more heat. Okay. So in short, what is the definition? Heat sink is designed to remove heat from the transistor and dissipate into the surrounding air. So these are the heat sink difference. Now thermal consideration means, remember, heat sink is also has one parameter, that is thermal resistance. Okay, means if the value of the thermal resistance will be low, then the speed of heating will be high, means faster heat will be dissipated. Lower the resistance, faster the heat will be dissipated. So factors affecting the heat dissipation is, first of all, power. Means how much power is dissipating by the transistor. Okay. Next is efficiency of the transferring of the heat between the transistor junction and the case. Mm-hmm. And the third one is difference between the temperature of the heat sink and the temperature of the surrounding. So those all effects should be considered for the power amplifiers. So these are the important parameters. Means which type of heat sink we are using, what is the capacity of it, what is the temperature, what is the heat dissipation. So these all criteria should be keep in mind while designing. So power transistor heat sinking means, just to understand, maximum power handled by any particular device that depends on temperature also. For example, 100 watt transistor will provide more power handling capacity than the 10 watt transistors. Okay. So in short, we can say proper heat sinking technique will allow operation of device at about one half of its maximum power rating. Or we can say, if suppose there is some temperature limitation, if that limitation will cross, then power handling capacity will reduce. If there is any temperature rating of the device, then after that rating, handling capacity will be reduced. For example, in bipolar transistors, we'll use germanium and silicon. So silicon has a temperature rating up to 200 degrees centigrade, but germanium has up to 100 degrees centigrade. So heat sinking depends on these two materials also. You know, the average power depends upon the voltage into current, VC into IC. So power dissipation is allowed only up to maximum temperature. Power dissipation allowed up to maximum temperature. Above this temperature, either capacity will start to reduce or it can be zero. Reducing capacity, we can say derating. So see, this is the power derating, the curve, means the power with respect to the ambient temperature. So up to 80 degree centigrade, the capacity is constant. But after this, the power handling capacity, power derating capacity will start to reduce. And after some time, it becomes zero. So you are understanding that the power handling or power dissipating capacity of heat sink depends on the temperature. Okay. this is as per the case temperature. When the case temperature is 200 degree centigrade, after that power handling capacity is zero. Means it can handle up to 200 degree centigrade. So if you, it's not necessary to provide a derating curve. See, if you want to calculate the dissipated power at particular temperature, okay. So first you should know that what is the initial temperature and power dissipation at the initial temperature, then the difference between those temperatures multiplied by derating factor. We'll see this with one example. Okay. Determine what maximum dissipation will be allowed for 80 watt silicon transistor rated at 25 degree centigrade. If derating is required above 25 degree centigrade, derating factor is 0.5 watt per degree centigrade, and case temperature is 125 degree centigrade. And they want to know what is maximum dissipation. The formula for maximum dissipation is, see here, initial dissipation minus difference of temperature multiplied by the factor, derating factor. So initial temperature was given 25, that is set temperature. For 80 watt silicon transistor, temperature is fixed, that is 25. So initial temperature is given 25 minus difference of temperature is 125 minus 25 multiplied derating factor. So power dissipation for this particular transistor will be 30 watt at 125 degree centigrade. Means power handling capacity will be 30 watt at 125 degree centigrade. So in this way, you can calculate at 130, you can calculate at 140, you can calculate at 200. So you can calculate the power dissipation at different temperature. Okay. Now, thermal analogy of power transistor is, if we check the thermal analogy, so there are some parameters like junction temperature, case temperature, ambient temperature, all of the important parameters by the device heat handling capacity. So see how it is. See in this figure, I have taken this all this concept from the book Bonestate. See here, in this case, this is your ambient, this is your heat sink, insulator and case. Again, listen, ambient, this is your heat sink, this is your insulator, this is your transistors. Okay. So now in this transistor, this is your junction temperature, junction. So I'm writing here it J for junction. Okay. Now this is your case. So I'm giving this name case. Okay. Now here what is connected? Heat sink. So heat sink is represented by S. Now here what is connect? Ambient. So I'm writing it A. Okay, listen carefully. Upper side there is a junction, so I'm writing here J. Then there is a case, so I'm writing here case. Here what is connected? Here heat sink. So I'm writing here S for heat sink. And the lower one is ambient, I'm writing here. So see the thermal resistance between junction and the case is theta JC. Between case and heat sink is theta CS. Between heat sink and ambient is theta SA. Between J and C is theta JC. Between case and this heat sink, theta CS. Between sink and the ambient, theta SA. Okay. And this is your ambient temperature. This is your power dissipation. Okay. So total resistance is, thermal resistance is the addition of all. Theta JC, theta CS, theta S, because these all are this thermal resistance. Okay, so power dissipation depends on all these parameters up to here to here. Now, if you, this is the combination of all the resistance. Now, if we apply Kirchhoff law, what is the junction temperature, TJ? So, see here, this is your power dissipation. Apply power dissipation equal to these two terms. One is TA across this and one across this. If you're understanding this, this power dissipation equals to this plus this. And this is your TA दिस इज समेशन ऑफ ऑल द रेजिस्टेंस मल्टीप्लाई बाय योर पावर. ओके, सो पी डी इंटू थीटा जे. थीटा जे मीन्स समेशन ऑफ ऑल द थर्मल रेजिस्टेंस प्लस डीए. अगेन लिसन, जंक्शन टेम्परेचर मीन्स वी आर टेकिंग दिस टोटल. टोटल इज डिवाइडेड इन टू पार्ट. दिस पार्ट अप टू दिस पार्ट इट इज डीए एंड अप टू हेयर वॉट इज adding all the thermal resistance multiply with the power. So we'll get the junction temperature. Junction temperature means this top to bottom total temperature. Again listen, junction temperature is from this top to this bottom. So it is divided in two part. One part is TA, this part is TA, and the upper part is total thermal resistance multiply by the power, theta into PD. Okay, so from this expression you can calculate the power dissipation. TJ minus TA upon theta J. TJ minus TA upon theta J means summation of all resistance, theta JC, theta CS, theta SC. Now there is one problem exercise. Generally it is asked in the university exams also, so it is an important question. A silicon power transistor is operated with a heat sink. Theta SC is given 1.5 and the transistor is rated at 150 watt, 25 degree centigrade, theta JC 0.5, and the mounting insulation has theta CS. So what maximum power can be dissipated if the ambient temperature is 40 degree and TJ max is 200? Okay, so in short, first of all, understand the numerical. What is asked in the question? Maximum power. And the maximum power is TJ minus TA. TJ minus TA and in the denominator theta JC, theta theta JC, theta CS and theta SA. You have to identify which parameters are given here. Okay, so now theta junction temperature and ambient temperature. You should understand first of all these are parameters. Junction temperature is given 200. Okay, so junction temperature is 200 and the ambient temperature is 25 because transistor rated at 25 degrees centigrade. Okay, that is the transistor temperature, but we want ambient temperature. Ambient temperature is ambient temperature is 40 degrees centigrade. Okay. So now these two parameters calculate. TJ is given given here. TJ is 200 and this ambient is TA. TJ minus TA is now theta JC is 0.5, theta S is 1.5, theta C is 0.6. What is the formula? TJ minus TA means 200 minus TA is 40 upon addition of these means 1.5 plus 0.6 and plus 0.5. Solve this, then you will have the power dissipation. 0.5, 0.6, 1.5, so 61.5. So in this way, we have learned the concept of heat sink. Keep sharing, keep learning. God bless.